Orange is a simple tool that you can use for machine learning. You can start quite simple, and you can use Orange to see your data and your results without having to understand everything. In this series, we're going to show examples of machine learning using the Orange software. This includes supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and also how to evaluate your machine learning. The videos will be in very simple language and suitable for anyone, even if you're new to machine learning. If you haven't already, download the Orange software from this webpage and let's get started. Now, Orange is quite big, which means when you download it, it can take a bit of time. Also, when you first open Orange, it doesn't open. It does, but it just takes so long. So you really have to just wait and wait. Depending on the speed of your computer, it might take a few seconds. So downloading and opening Orange takes time. Here is Orange with a new file. Most of the screen is a blank canvas because we haven't done anything yet. On the left, we can see a menu system. We have the normal menus at the top, but underneath we have sections called Data, Transform, Visualize, Model, Evaluate, and Unsupervised. Now inside these we have widgets, and we can select a widget and then drag it onto the canvas. We wait, and here's our canvas with our widget on it. This one is called Paint Data. If I click on it, I can start to create data on it. And then I can close the window. Now, if I want to see that data, I can use another widget called Data Table. To see the data, I connect the data to the data table. Can you see the line? Now I click on the data table and I can see the data. If I want to visualize it, I can go to the visualize section. Now I can select a scatter plot. And again, connect the data to the scatter plot. I click on the scatter plot and we can see now we have a visualization of our data. Close the window again. If I want to save that file, I can use a normal system, File and Save, File Save As. Now I want to add some type of machine learning. I'm not too sure where it is. So I can right click my mouse and this menu comes up and I can start typing it. This one's called K-Means. Ah, here it is. I can click it here. Now the widgets appeared. I can connect my data again. Go to K-Means. If I click on it, we have some settings. Here I've got fixed number of clusters. K-Means is an unsupervised machine learning algorithm. It's also an algorithm that does clustering. Clustering is where we put data points together in similar items. So here it's got 3. So it's going to split the data into 3 clusters. Now we want to see the output. So we're going to go back to the scatter plot. So we created another one. Let's join machine learning to the scatter plot. And now we want to see the clusters. Can you see the different colors? We can click on Show Color Regions to show it a bit better. So can you see the machine learning algorithm has decided that these clusters that is colored in blue are more similar than these clusters are similar to each other in green and these clusters are red. So this machine learning algorithm puts data points that are similar together in groups. These groups are called clusters. Now that was three clusters. Imagine if we had two clusters. Well, we can change that. We can say two clusters. We've changed the setting. Let's go back to our diagram. Ah, we can see now we have blue and red two clusters. If we don't want to decide ourselves, we can actually ask the algorithm to say, what do you think is best? So we're going to give it a choice between 2 and 9 clusters. And here it has some type of score called a silhouette score that's saying it's better to split it in 2 clusters. We know what that looks like, but we'll check again. And here we are. So you can see this is the result. So we've got our data, we've got our machine learning algorithm, and here we've viewed the output, the results. So that wasn't too difficult, was it? Finally, in this example, we created our own data. But we can get data from other places. If, for example, we want to use the data we can get with Orange, perhaps we want to use data sets. If we click on the icon, we can see we have these data sets. A popular one is Iris. So if we start putting IR, we can see here we have the Iris data set. So we can use that. If we want to use our own data, we can use File. File, and then click, and then we can open up our own file and use the data in that. So let's load this data, close the window, and if we want to see the data, we can connect it to a data table, and here's our data. So very similar to our data that we painted, we created in Orange. So very similar. So we can use different sources of data to use in our Orange software. And we have many other different types of machine learning algorithms. We'll see them in the videos to come. Now, this video series is accompanied by some articles. So if you need more information, go to this website and then you can click on the articles and they will give you more information about the machine learning and the evaluation, like the confusion matrix. And also there's some examples and also some exercises. Now, if you've gained anything from this video, please remember to click the like. If you want to know when the next videos are coming out, I suggest you subscribe and click the notification bell. Hope to see you for the next video.